So welcome back again, our next part of the revision of the class of physics, and please share and like and comment. So let me start. So we all are already studied about the what is the refraction. So there is a very important things that is medium. So there are two types of medium. First one is rare and another one is denser. So these two types of medium are there. So always remember that. So these two types of medium, first one is rare and other one is denser. So when the rays is going from the rare to denser or denser to rare, then its bending intensity is a different. So look at here, when the rays is going from the rare to denser medium, then it going towards the like that, but it bends. It bends where? Towards the normal. Where? Towards the normal. So always remember that when the rays is going from to rare to denser, so it bend towards the normal. So it bend towards the normal. So this is a first way for the refraction. And another one is when the rays is going from denser to rare. So what happened? Look at, if the rays is going like that, so it is bends away from the normal. So it's going to be like that. It is comes to like that here, but it is bends away from the normal. It is bends away from the normal. So that is a two things. When the rays going from to rare to denser, then it bends towards the normal. When it is going from the denser to rare, then it is away from the normal. Clear? So next one is the laws of refraction. So laws of refraction are very important, and this is same as the laws of reflection. So what is the laws of refraction? The incident ray, the refracted ray, and the normal. So in the laws of reflection is the wherever the place of refracted rays, it is written as reflected rays. So here the incident ray, reflected ray, and normal to the interface of two transparent medium at the point of incidence or all lie in the same plane. So the incident ray, refracted ray, and the normal lie in the same plane. The second one is the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is a constant. So what is sine I upon sine R? Sine of angle of incidence upon sine of angle of refraction is what? Constant. So this is a laws of refraction, very important for the point of view of examination. And this constant is known as what? Refractive index. So this constant is known as refractive index, and this refractive index are two types. First one is absolute and relative. So firstly, we are talk about the relative. So this is a relative. So what is the relative refractive index? Look at the formula. V1 upon V2. So relative refractive index is the ratio of speed in first medium to the speed in second medium. Clear? What is the relative refractive index? Relative refractive index is what? It is the ratio of speed in first medium upon speed in second medium. If it is written as N21, N21 means a ray is going from the second to the first medium. N21 means the refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. This means the rays is going from one to second medium. Clear? And the N12 means the rays is going from 2 to 1. So speed of second medium to the speed of first medium is very important for the examination point of view and the numerical portion. So what is the relative refractive index? Relative refractive index is could be the n is equal to v1 upon v2 and it is 1 and 2 means the relative refractive index is going from the 1 to 2. A rays is going from one medium to another medium or second medium. So this is a relative refractive index. And what is the absolute refractive index? Absolute refractive index is always respect to a vacuum or air. What is the absolute refractive index? Absolute refractive index is the ratio of speed of light in vacuum to the speed of light in any medium. So this is the difference between relative and absolute. So here formula is what? N is equal to C upon V. C is the speed of light and V is the speed of light in any medium. And one thing, another one, the speed of light is the relative. So what is the means of this? N12 is the reciprocal of 1N21. दैट मीन्स कि अगर कोई रेज 1 से 2 में जा रही है तो उसका रेसिप्रोकल जो होगा वो उसके इनवर्स के इक्वल होगा. ठीक है ना, क्लियर है? यानी कि 1N2 इज इक्वल टू द 1 upon 2N1, जस्ट अपोजिट. क्लियर? सो दैट इज़ अ रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. नाउ द रिफ्रैक्शन फिनोमेना इज अकर्ड इन स्फेरिकल लेंस. व्हाट इज the refraction phenomena is occurred in spherical lens. So spherical lens is a transparent medium bound by two surfaces of which one or both surfaces are curved. So what are the spherical lenses? Spherical lenses are transparent medium bound by two surfaces which one or both surfaces are curved. जिसका एक या दोनों सरफेस कैसे होंगे? कर्व्ड होंगे. और ये एक ट्रांसपेरेंट मीडियम से बाउंडेड रहेगा. सो दिस इज टू टाइप्स, कॉन्वेक्स लेंस एंड कॉन्केव लेंस. सो इट इज़ अ प्रॉपर कॉन्वेक्स एंड इट इज़ अ प्रॉपर कॉन्केव लेंस. रिमेंबर दैट. एंड देयर आर मैनी टाइप्स ऑफ. सो व्हाट आर द आइडेंटिफिकेशन? थिन फ्रॉम कॉर्नर्स. सो लुक एट हियर, थिन फ्रॉम कॉर्नर. सो थिन फ्रॉम कॉर्नर, क्लियर? थिन फ्रॉम कॉर्नर एंड thick at center, and it is also known as converging lens, and the opposite as the thick at corners and thin at center, it is known as diverging. Diverging की spelling यहाँ पर थोड़ा सा mistake है, तो हम लोग आगे देखेंगे. So next is the rules for drawing ray diagram in a lenses. So there are 3 rules in lenses. In mirror there are 4 rules. In mirror 4 rules, but in lenses only 3 rules. Clear? So look at here. The next one, first rule is a ray parallel to principal axis will pass through focus. यानी कि parallel through the principal axis and pass through a focus. Second one is for concave lens, parallel to the principal axis and appear to coming from the focus. Clear? Second one is just reverse, a ray passing through the focus or going towards the focus is becomes parallel after refraction. Clear in both? And the third one is a ray going from the optical center is going without any deviation in both convex or concave. Clear? So there are the 6 cases for the convex lens. First one is when object is at infinity. We all are know that when object at is infinity, then rays coming from the parallel, and parallel rays after refraction is passing from the focus. So the aim is at focus. Here one thing is, in case of mirror we are denoted center of curvature at C, but in case of lens we are representing center of curvature at 2f2 or 2f1. Clear? So the image is found at F2 and the rays are actual meted, so real and inverted, and the size of the image is highly diminished. Second one is the when object is beyond 2F1, and in the case of mirror the object is beyond C. So here same, this is a C or 2F1, The first ray is parallel after refraction is passing from the focus. Another ray is going from the optical center and they are meted at point A dash. And this is, so between C2 or F2, that means 2F2 and F2. So the image position is the F2 and 2F2, and the rays are actual meted, so real and inverted, and the size is time nist. And the third case is when object is at 2F1. 2F1 is the case when the object at center of curvature. So when the object at center of curvature, the image is also at the center of curvature. So the first one rays is parallel to the principal axis and going from the focus. Another ray is going from the optical center. They meet at 2F2. That means the ray object at 2F1 and image at 2F2. Rays are actually meted, so real are inverted, and the size will be same because the same points are there. And the next case is when object is between F1 and 2F1. So just reverse, first parallel, after reflection it's going passing from the focus, another ray is going from the optical center, meted at beyond 2F2. So the rays, the image position is beyond 2F2, rays are actually meted, so real and inverted, and size is enlarged. When object is at F1, so the image position at infinity, because the rays firstly going from the parallel and after reflection is going from the focus, another ray is going from the optical center, they all are parallel, so that means we can consider that they meet at infinity. Clear? Nature of the image, real and inverted, and the size will be highly large. Clear? And the last case for the convex lens is when object is between F1 and optical center. In case of mirror, concave mirror, the last case is the object between pole and focus. So here same case is there. The first ray is parallel to the principal axis, passing from the focus, another ray is optical center, and they all are separated from each other. So we can consider if we extended at back side, so they meet at behind the in front of the lens. So the same side of the lens as object. जिधर object है उधर ही आपका image formed होगा, और rays यहाँ पर actual meet नहीं कर रही है, so virtual and direct, and the size is comparatively is large. So these are the cases of convex lens. And there are two cases for concave lens. The first one is infinity. The object at infinity, rays coming from the object is parallel and it appears to coming from a focus. So the image will be at F1. The nature of the image is virtual and direct, and the size of the image will be highly tarnished. When object is placed between infinity and optical center, here is only two second case. The firstly parallel to the principal axis appears to coming from the focus, another ray is going from the optical center, they are meted in front of the lens. So the rays are actually meted or not? So the rays are not actually meted, so the image nature will be virtual and direct, and the image formed between F and O, and the size will be dimmed. If you have any problems regarding the any topic, so you can comment, and please share and like this video to get other students and they get knowledge from this video. Thank you everyone.